So this is where the Bombardier and the Navigator would have got into the aircraft. Adam would have done it, being the shorter gentleman that they were.
Yeah.
They would have jumped, grabbed hold of here, swung their legs up, got them up here, slid in towards that way so they could crawl into the nose. Once you're in the nose, there's actually an awful lot of space in there. You can fit a significant number of people. I've done it.
Yeah.
I think I had 8 people in there at Riyadh.
Did you?
Yeah. All French air crew had 8 of them in there.
Mind where you're walking, guys.
Bombay's not very big. It only carried a maximum of 6,000 pounds ordnance. There were points on the wings where they could actually mount an external 6,000 pounds. So short hauls, if they're going to France or something, say, they could take 12,000 in total.
Did they regularly use the external?
No. It was a very, very short haul thing. The extra 6,000 pounds. Hold on to the gun. Gun mount and just move the new gun mount up there.
Simple,
easy, quick to do. Most of these guys were about 18 years of age. Same with the tail gunner and the ball turret gunner. I've got a good story about a ball turret gunner I can tell you about when we get to it.
Yep.
His camera is take pictures and video of where the bombs were hitting for intelligence to make sure that they were hitting where they were supposed to with the northern bomb site. You're in the most armoured position in the aircraft. You're surrounded by armour plating steel, and you've also got 23mm bulletproof glass. So 20mm, which is what the Germans are using, is not going to penetrate the glass, even if it's dead flat.
Absolutely.
The glass is just too thick. Thank you.
flying.
Yes.
Like you, but they
pay a bit more than we do.
Yeah.